I think that it's really hard to listen to Genesis and to not get obsessed by their music. It's like everything is configured in a way to attract you. Some roadies even called it their own genre. Tony Banks has described it as visual music. Doesn't sound that special, but in a way, Genesis always moves the imagination. Of course, other bands have done that as well, and Genesis knows that. Many tracks are based on the stuff that they like, but if it was only visual music, it would be pretty boring. One thing that they all have said is that the music here is fun, and that they played what they like. And back to Tony, he's proud of all the music done with Genesis. He has dismissed some, but he never used the word hate when talking about a Genesis song. Well, maybe Hot Sun 5. It's interesting, really. Playing or singing the Genesis music is really fun, both on its simplicity and its complexity. Maybe a simple beat will stick and then the complex one will challenge you to do better. If it's not that, then you will get trapped by its characters, situations, ambience, sounds, whatever moves you to imagine what's probably happening on the track without even reading the entire lyrics. Maybe some people just dance or act to Genesis. That also works because the music has some very cool changes that challenge, once again, any interpretation. This band also sounds great. Every instrument used was a state of the art, and every live play actually being played on stage with some really cool effects that accompany the music perfectly. What happens when you feel like not listening to Genesis, but something that feels like it, yet heavier or softer? Well, listen to more Genesis. Every album has a distinct feeling that motivates you to keep listening to each one somehow, and even then you know every song. Well, there are tons of extra tracks, almost as much as the published songs. There are also session tapes, special concert shows, bootlegs of every show, different mixes. If that wasn't enough, all of the Genesis members have a musically successful solo career. Or a harvest successful farm. My point is, you will definitely find more Genesis on the solo careers. Weird chords and changing long tracks, listen to Tony. Cool riffs and sentimental ballads, listen to Mike. Harp synth like eclectic playing, listen to Steve. African rhythms and character-driven sounds, listen to Peter. Slick jazz hooks and moving hits, listen to Phil. Lyrical guitars and unknown instruments, listen to Anthony Phillips. And I don't know how to describe Ray Wilson, but Lemon Yellow Sun and Guranga are really good tracks. And lastly, if you really don't know where to go with Genesis, I imagine that you have done an album already. You are more than motivated at this point.